The children of God are a group of nations, because on that day they shall reign that 1,000 years with Jesus. You know, and that's why the Lord said, all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, saith the Lord of hosts. So I say to you tonight that continue. I know a lot of my brothers and sisters who come this prayer line and Bible study, they love God. They love God. My sister that leads us in worship, I know they love God. They love God in sincerity, and you can see it. I pray to God that we all continue to love God in sincerity. We can all continue to be thirsty and hungry for God. And God will come to feed us, that we come to have relationship with God all the days of our life, that we shall never forget God, because we have nowhere else to go. There's nowhere else save. Is it the wicked people, politicians, and wicked world countries one is good to run to? We are saved in the hand of Jesus. So I thank God for your life, all my brothers and sisters who are thirsty and hungry for God. You love God. That's why a lot of people come to this prayer line and Bible study. They love God. Continue to love God unto the end, and God will come to call you more in and more and more and more relationship with God. Amen. So finally, we go to the book of Jude, chapter, I read from 14, Jude, that's before, the second to the last book before Revelation. So Jude 14, I read quickly, and we come to an end tonight. And Enoch also, the seventh from Adam, prophesied of this, saying, behold, the Lord cometh with 10,000s of his saints. So those that love God and walk with God all the days of their life, that worship in spirit and truth, when I was saying that have intimacy, they shall come with God. They shall be among those 10,000s of saints when God will come back. You know, to execute judgment upon all and to convince all that are ungodly among them, and of all the ungodly deeds which they have ungodly committed, and of all their hard speeches, you see, hard speeches which ungodly sinners have spoken against God. You see, all these hard speeches they have spoken against God, all these ungodly sinners, all their hard speeches, they will pay that time, you know, when the Lord cometh with 10,000 of his saints, you know. So now, he said, these are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lust, and their mouths speaketh great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration, because of advantage. I told you that those who worship pastors, men pleasers on your job, who go to the director, the commissioner to gossip about you. Is he a minister? Is he a governor, president? They go in the back to gossip so that they can have advantage. You see? For people's advantage. These are ungodly people. If they know God, they will be praising God and worshiping God, not men. They will not be kissing up to men. Men pleasers, you know. So, 16, these are murmurers, complainers, walking after their own lust, and their mouths speaketh great swelling words, having men's persons in admiration because of advantage. But beloved, remember ye the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time. You see how they mock Jesus Christ every time Easter comes, when they want to do a resurrection Sunday. And he said, they mock Jesus. Good Friday, they mock. When Christmas comes, they try to mock Jesus. They try to downplay Jesus. They try to say Jesus was never born, that no Mary, that it's all lies. They try to downplay the resurrection of Jesus. They mock churches, they mock God, they mock Christians, they mock Jesus. And he said, that's what he's saying. He said, how that day they told you there should be mockers in the last time, who should walk after their own ungodly lusts. You see, all the mockers, they walk in their own ungodly lusts. Even we have politicians who mock God, you know, and all these radio station, TV station, news medias, the same propaganda machine that they use in telling lies against African countries, to put Africans down, to put black people down, to call black people lazy in America, that they live on welfare, that they are not educated, that black people are stupid. All the negatives they speak about black people, the same thing they do to God. You see? At least we are humans. They talk all kind of negatives about black people to put the news media. Always negative about black people to put black people down. They are the one who portray, make all other races to come against black. to view black people as bad people. But we are not bad people. We are created by God. If you are a child of Jesus, born again, baptized, filled of the Holy Ghost, you are a saint of Jesus. It doesn't matter how much news media and racist churches. We have white racist churches too. Do the same. They will not condemn racism. They will not condemn anything. Because they themselves are racist. You see, these are the things that we deal with. And we have to talk about this, you know, so that people's eyes should open. Those who want to listen, let them listen. You see? So, you see how that they told you there should be mockers in the last time. Who should walk after their own ungodly lusts? These be they that separate themselves sensual, having not the spirit. You see, they don't have the spirit of God. You see, I told you, did I not say at the beginning when they don't have the spirit of God. No person who has spirit of God will forget God, or who have spirit of God will be doing evil or doing things against God. When God say, I don't like this, and that's exactly what they want to do, to rebel against God. No. You see? But ye, beloved, building up yourselves on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. And of some have compassion, making a difference. And others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire. Hating even the garments spotted by the flesh. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power. But now and forevermore. Amen. Father, we just thank you for tonight, O Lord. Father God, we thank you. You are God, you are real, O God. Thank you for your Holy Spirit, O God, for we know those that are led by the Spirit of the living God are the children of God, O Lord, Father God, that we, your children, will never forget you, O Lord, Father God. We're going to have relationship, O God. We're going to be hungry and thirsty for you, that you're going to pull us more and more and more of you, O God. Lord, Father, I pray tonight, O Lord, Father God, as those people on WhatsApp or YouTube hear this word tonight, O God, that, Lord, Father God, that your Holy Spirit cause them to hear this, that those who have forgotten you, O God, walking in their imagination of their hearts, in their evils and wickedness and blasphemy and mockers, O God, that they will repent of their sins while they are alive, because it's not too late, O God. And that's why we share this tonight, O God. Thank you, Lord, Father God. We bless you. We worship you. We thank you. Let your name be glorified, O God. Bless my brothers and sisters, O God. Bless their household, O God. May the blood of Jesus Christ come to cover them, O God. Lord, Father God, I pray that the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ will come to pierce every nooks and corner of this world, that many be saved into your hands, O God. We thank you, Lord, Father. We pray, Lord, Father, every prayer has come to the throne of grace and worship and praise as a sweet smelling savour unto you, O God. Receive glory, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, O God. Oh, Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name, we pray tonight. Amen. Amen. Amen.